Assalamu alaikum, dear students. In the previous lecture, we talked about voice and its kinds, you know, active voice and the passive voice. Then we learned the various, with the general rules governing the formation of passive voice. Now let's learn something more about this topic, that is active voice and passive voice. Now, I have here written the sentence, Bashir writes a letter. Here Bashir is subject, writes is verb in present simple, a letter is object, and this sentence is in active voice. And I told you, when the subject and the doer are same, such a sentence is said to be in active voice. Now, a letter is written by Bashir. Here a letter is subject, is written is verb, and Bashir is agent or doer of the action. Now, number first. By plus agent. It is used only when the agent is definite and clear. When the agent is definite, clear and important. So we can say, by plus agent is used only when the agent is definite and important. For example, Shakespeare wrote Hamlet. The sentence is in active voice. Subject, verb, and object. Now I can change it into passive voice. Hamlet was written by Shakespeare. Now in this sentence, the agent is definite and clear. That is why we have used by. Now I can give you another example. Sahil was making a kite. Now again, a kite was being made by Sahil. Here the agent is definite and clear. That is why we use by. Now, another. Now, number second is, by plus agent is not used when the agent is vague. Vague means when the agent is not clear. For example, someone has picked my pocket. This sentence is in active voice. Someone subject, this is verb, and this is object. Now when we want to change this sentence into passive voice, we write, my pocket has been picked. There is no need to write by someone, because this agent is not definite and important. That is why we should avoid this by. Another example is, somebody has put out the light. Again, we can change it into passive voice like this. The light has been put out. There is no need to write by somebody, because this is not definite, this is not important. That is why we should avoid it. Now, number third, with plus object. Now, there are some sentences where we use with and the object. And when we use with and the object, it indicates means or instrument. Or we can say, when there is the mention of some material or substance in the sentence, there is the mention of some material. Material or substance. We do not use by. We use with. By plus object. It indicates agent. as we have seen in the examples last time. Now I can write here the example. Gaze filled the kitchen. Now this sentence is in active voice. I want to make the passive voice of this sentence. I should write, the kitchen was filled with gaze. By gaze is not possible here. That is why I have mentioned with plus object indicates means or instrument, or when there is a mention of some material or substance, it is better to use with. Gaze filled the kitchen. We can write, the kitchen was filled with gaze. Another example, pant covered the lock. Now we want to change this active sentence into passive voice. I should write, the lock was covered with paint. By paint is not possible here. So I should write, the lock was covered with paint. Now there is number fourth. Sometimes we have some sentences in the active voice wherein we find two objects. Now some sentences in the active voice are there wherein we find two objects. Number fourth is when we have two objects. For example, and such sentences, they are usually asked in the examination. The police gave him a reward. Now, when we look at this sentence, what we find? The police is subject. Gave is verb. Him is object. And a reward is again object. The object which is close to verb, this is called as indirect object. And this object is called as direct object. Or we can say this him, this is first object, and this is second object. So in this sentence, there are two objects. One is him, this is closed verb, and this is called as indirect object. Then there is a reward, this is direct object. Now as such, there are two possible ways by which such sentences can be changed into passive voice. We can make either this indirect object as a subject in the passive voice, or this direct object as the subject in the passive voice. Now, when you are using this direct object as the subject in the passive voice, this indirect object, it is expressed by a preposition to. So when you are using, why I tell you this? Because sometimes in your examination, in your question paper, the sentence is in active voice and the object is already underlined, and you are required to make that object as the subject in the passive voice. So if you intend to make this direct object as a subject in the passive voice, then this indirect object should be expressed by a preposition to. Now I will change this sentence into passive voice, and there are two ways. First, I will use this indirect object. Usually we use this indirect object while changing such sentences from active voice to passive voice. Now, him will be changed into he. He was given a reward by the police. This is one possible way. So this is one possible way we have made the passive of this sentence. Now another is, we can use the direct object. A reward was given to him. So that is why I told you this indirect object, it needs here preposition to. So I can change this. A reward was given to him by the police. So, in nutshell, we can say when we have the sentence in the active voice which has two objects, we can use either direct object or the indirect object. When you are using direct object as a subject in the passive voice, this indirect object needs preposition to. Now another is, fifth is, object complement. I will write here an example. We elected him. Now in this sentence, we have subject, we have verb, and we have object. But this sentence, we elected him, we only know that there is some person who has been elected. But we don't know what position he occupies. So this object is not complete. It needs some word, some phrase, so that it may convey us the complete sense. What word or what phrase is needed to complete the sense of this object? That is called as complement. We can write here, we elected him captain. We elected him chairman, or whatever you can write. So we elected him chairman. We can say this chairman. Here it is complement. It completes the meaning of this object. This is called as complement. Object complement. And this complement should not be confused with the object. Mostly I have told you, when we change a sentence from active voice to passive voice, the object becomes subject in the passive voice. Here this complement should not be confused with the object. We should not write like this, chairman was elected by, this is incorrect, this is wrong. While changing such sentences from active voice to passive voice, the object, it becomes subject in the passive voice, and complement, it remains unchanged. Complement remains unchanged. Complement is unchanged. Now I will change this. We elected him chairman. We can simply write, him is changed into he. He was elected chairman. He was elected chairman. Likewise, they kept me waiting. They kept me. This me has not complete meaning. I should write, they kept me waiting. I will change it into passive. I was kept waiting. Now there are some other sentences as well, and we shall discuss them next time. Thank you.